Hey guys, Cosby here, and today we're going to be reviewing the metallic Cruz Ramirez. She is a part of the Scavenger Hunt series, and as you can see, she has a special metallic design. This is the regular Cruz Ramirez. I'll put a little card up on the screen for you guys to watch my review on that. And I thought I'd also compare the Fireball Beach Cruz to this Cruz. I won't be comparing the Dynaco one or the Rusty's one, as they don't follow the same body shape as the metallic one does, because you can see by the diecast and the art, this is before she became a racer during the end of the film. So this is my first scavenger hunt car. I found this the other week, last Saturday, when I found my Shiny Wax Next Gen and the Sputter Stop Next Gen. I'm going to go again next Saturday because I've realised they restock every fortnight on a Saturday or Friday. So anyone in the UK who goes to Asda to look for cars, I'm pretty sure they restock, at least for my store, they restock every fortnight on a Saturday or Friday. So you just got to miss out that week and then the next week go. But yeah, without further ado, let's take a look around the packaging. As you can see here, we've got the Disney Pixar Cars logo. Unlike the other two, there is no blur in the picture here. It's just, you can see all the rocks. We have a Art of Cruz Ramirez here, which looks really cool. And as you can see down here, it says Metallic Cruz Ramirez Special Metallic Edition. I must point out, some of you probably already know, these scavenger hunt cars aren't any harder to find than the normal cars, but it just in case some of you don't know, they are just as, easy or hard, however easy cars are for you to find, as any other car. There is no difference, it's just scavenger hunt because they're metallic. So they're not rare to find, there's not a certain limited amount of them made. They're just as easy or hard, depending on if cars are easy or hard for you to find, as the rest. Up here just a scavenger hunt, and we've got a picture of the car, no background because it didn't obviously appear anywhere, so that is another difference about the packaging. And we have the car's logo up there again, and apart from a little bit of darkening, this Cruz is really hard to actually differentiate from the normal picture of the prototype picture, I suppose. But yeah, this without further ado, let's get this Cruz Ramirez opened out of her packaging. Alright then guys, so here is Cruz Ramirez, the golden one out of the packaging. I must say this Cruz Ramirez looks absolutely amazing. It's a lot better than the actual normal Cruz Ramirez in my opinion, because it's just the build quality, if you know what I mean, just feels better. One difference I did notice is if you look at the rims here, you can't see the brake calipers. However, if you look at the Cruz Ramirez, the normal one, you can see the brake caliper there, which isn't obviously accurate because the brakes don't go round with the wheel. So I don't know why they did that. It does look very weird. So that's a bit of a shame, but maybe the 2018 version of Cruz Ramirez has been changed to follow suit of this. The only similarities they sort of have is obviously the wind mirrors. Obviously it's the same car, but you know, the physical aspects of the model, apart from the shape too, but you get what I mean. So obviously Cruz is one of the main characters in the film, along with McQueen. There's many, many places he appears, so I can't do my normal thing of saying where they appear. But obviously this Cruz Ramirez didn't appear anywhere in the film because it's a metallic special one. The other metallic cars in this series are Lightning McQueen, Bobby Swift, I think Marilyn, which is a car that's seen at the end of Cars 1 in Radio Springs, Mario Andretti, I think Vuzine, the Cars 1 version, is getting a metallic release. And I think Nick Stickers as well, maybe missing one there. So, but there's the ones that are getting released, which is pretty cool. This Cruz Ramirez is probably one of the best ones because it's really nice gold, but that McQueen would be nice to get too. So hopefully I can find that when I go next week. I guess we can just get onto the physical review of Cruz Ramirez now. As we come up to the front here, we've got her expression, which is very, very nice. Her brown eyes, the eyelashes. You can see the gold paint just glitters here. I don't know what this is here. It's a bit of paint dribble, but you can just see in the light, this paint is so nice. She's got very sleek lights here. The wheels, very nice design indeed. You can actually see that's gold behind her as well. So yeah, like I said, they're different to the normal version. I must point out the Fireball Beach one doesn't have them brake calipers either. The Rusty's Racing Center logo looks really cool. Rusty's Racing Center Team 95. You see her doors here, really, really nice. Fuel cap up there, which is also gold because of the normal die cast, it's just yellow. As we come to the back, you can see our lights here, some sort of logo, and the license plate, which reads CO1 Texas-06A, so it's Texas instead of Texas. And the number plate is to reference the voice actor for Cruz. Her name's literally just gone out of my head. As I'm filming, her name's just gone right out of my head. We got the same design on the other side. I think it's Cristela Alonso or something like that. I'm not sure. I'm not going to try and say it when I've completely forgot. Yeah, it's exactly the same on the other side. There seems to be a dent there, which is quite familiar. Got a big open window there too. The base is not really much to say about that. It's not as many codes, I guess. So actually really stiff. This car is really stiff and feels like it's really well made, which is really, really cool. So yeah, I really do like this Cruz. It's probably, like I said, it probably is my favourite one. Let's just back her up a bit here. I feel like she's too close to the camera. Alright, so here is her in comparison to the regular version. I got mine along with Sterling, round about maybe May something. So I didn't get her on May 1st because it wasn't a single then. But I got her on probably sometime around that. Anyway, as you can see here, the expressions are pretty similar. Apart from the eyes seem to be slightly smaller on this one than they do this, which I think looks better. Eyelashes seem to be the same. As you go to the side, like I said, you got the difference in the rims. But apart from that, there's not a whole lot more differences. As you go to the back, exactly the same. You can't really see the logo on here. But I do think this gold looks so much better than the normal colour, because I'm not really a fan of yellow on most cars, unless it's like a proper supercar. Although the back Cruz with yellow does look pretty nice. They both also, I should point out, have metallic-y paint. If we just focus in on them here, as you can see that glisten, they both do have metallic-y paint, so it's not just the gold one that features that. I also will compare the muddy one, or not muddy one, sorry. That's the Francis Beltline one. I do have that, but I didn't think we should have compared that one. As you can just see here, it's the same thing, apart from the wheels and the base, which are different, and obviously the colour. So we place these two back here and get Gold or Cruz centre again. All right then, guys, that is it for this review on Cruz Ramirez, the golden version. If you did enjoy, make sure to give a like. If you have not already, please subscribe and make sure to turn on the post notification bells, because it's very helpful in notifying you guys when I make a video or a live stream. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching this review on Golden Cruz Ramirez, and as always, I will see you in the next review, guys.